Dr. Doreen Grand-Pichet
is a visionary in the field of autism. Now you can ask her questions on Ask Dr. Doreen.
I would love to know how to handle a child who gets into a meltdown because we refuse to give him chips or anything that is not good for him. We are tired of giving in to him just to keep the peace. He is verbal and turning 25 soon.
Oh, that's so difficult. I wish he was turning 5 because it's, of course, a lot harder when our children get older and these habits have become ingrained and now they're also much bigger and can object. But what I always like to go back to is just trying to give a very brief explanation, and I hope it'll help other parents as well. Brief explanation of what happens when a child has a tantrum, or actually what happens whenever we give in, right? Whether it's a tantrum or yelling or hitting or any kind of challenging behavior and we give in. If you can just think of things from the child's perspective. I scream, I tantrum, I hit, I yell, and I get what I want. Anything, any behavior that is followed by a reward will increase. Any behavior that is followed by a reward will increase. That is the first basic premise of operant conditioning. If you want something to increase, reward it. And that is essentially what has been happening. So every time he has tantrumed, you've given in. By giving in, you are rewarding him, right? You're saying the tantrum works. You tantrum, I give you what you want. And so you need to stop doing that and as soon as you possibly can. And honestly, I know it's a very scary thing when your child is 25, so you should probably have support and help before you do this, because I don't know how severe these tantrums are. The parents noted that this is a high functioning individual, so possibly not extremely severe, but I would still suggest that you have others there to help you, because when a 25-year-old, if you cut off the reinforcer, in other words, if you stop giving in to a 25-year-old, they might get very aggressive. I don't know, because at this point, the individual will be frustrated and they will be asking themselves, this worked for 25 years. How come it's not working anymore? And what happens is what we call an extinction burst. So the minute you stop attending to or giving in, the minute you cut off the reinforcer, the individual's behavior accelerates. It gets worse before it dies off. So there's this extinction burst. Extinction means you're no longer attending to that behavior. And so basically the individuals think about it from the person's point of view. They're thinking, this worked before. How come it's not working? Let me just yell louder. Let me scream a little bit harder. Let me hit. Let me do whatever it is so that they will give in again. And so it gets a little bit worse and you have to stay with it. You have to continue not giving in, at which point gradually it starts to get less and less. And then the individual realizes that this isn't working for me anymore. And then they will find another behavior. And that's where it's more important for you to come in and actually model or prompt a new behavior. In other words, I will not give in to you when you scream and cry, but I will give in to you when you ask nicely. And that's the way it goes, is that you ignore or do not give in to challenging behaviors, but you heavily reward appropriate behaviors. And again, it's a lot easier when the child is younger. It's a lot harder when this pattern of behavior has gone on for a long time. And believe me, I know it is very, very difficult for parents. I myself had a very difficult time with this when my children were younger. It, at any time in life, it's hard. I mean, think about it. Sometimes our spouses might tantrum, you know, and giving in is an easier way to deal with things. But in the long run, it's a very, very difficult thing.
Hey, thanks for watching Autism Live. To subscribe, click here. And if you'd like to check out some more of our videos, click here.